Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to RNN News. I am Yasmin Sultana. Headlines of the news. Rohingya situation one of worst human rights crisis. Gators. UN Netherlands quit support charges against Myanmar. August 30, 2018. Now into the details. Describing the Rohingya refugee situation as one of the worst humanitarian and human rights crises of the past year, Secretary General Antonio Guterres has called for international action to ensure Myanmar is held to account for the crimes of its security forces. Speaking at a Security Council session convened on Tuesday for the one-year anniversary of the start of the exodus of 720,000 Rohingyas, Bangladesh, Guterres also condemned the attacks by extremists against the security forces. However, he added that nothing can ever justify the disproportionate use of force against civilians and the horrendous violation of human rights violation by the security forces, urging United Nations by the divided Security Council. Guterres cited a report issued on Monday by a UN Human Rights Council UNHCR fact-finding team and said the human rights abuses amounted to the gravest crimes under international law. He thanked the Bangladesh government for its generosity in hosting the refugees and said more needs to be done by the world community, as only 33% of the 951 million UN appeal for assistance has been made and the monsoon season looms. The current crisis began in August 2017 with attacks on Myanmar security post by the Arakan Rohingya Salvation Army ARSA, which is led by Karachi-born Ataullah. The Myanmar armed forces and vigilantes retaliated brutally against the Rohingyas starting an exodus that began on August 25. Tariq Mohammed Ahmed, the British Minister of State for the UN who presided over the Security Council session, said that it should be prepared to use all the tools it has to ensure justice for the Rohingyas. The strongly worded report by the UNHCR team, headed by former Indonesian Attorney General Marzuki Dasuman, said that allegations of genocide against Myanmar officials should be referred to the International Criminal Court, ICC, or to a special tribunal. The Netherlands and Sweden backed the suggestions and asked the Security Council to refer the matter to the ICC, but Russia and China countered, saying that the situation required a non-confrontational approach and only a bilateral diplomatic solution involving Myanmar and Bangladesh would work. Myanmar's permanent representative, Ho Du Sung, said that his country did not accept the funding of the UNHCR team as it was based. However, he added that Myanmar does not condone human rights abuses and would take action against anyone guilty if there was evidence of their conduct. He alleged that the ARSA had set up terrorist base in some areas along the border with Bangladesh. Bangladesh Permanent Representative Masood bin Mumin said that in the light of the UNHCR team's report, it was imperative that the Security Council should act decisively. He said that the Rohingyas could not return to their homes in Rakhine State unless they were assured of their safety. For this, the Myanmar government should take several steps, like carving head speech, allowing free access to UN agencies for relief operations and dismantling internal camps for Rohingyas and giving them freedom of movement. Australian-born actor Kate Blanchett, who is a goodwill ambassador for the UN High Commissioner for Refugees, spoke at the Security Council session about her encounters with Rohingya refugees who told her harrowing tales of their experiences in Myanmar. She said that as a mother, she was moved by the plight of the children she met as she saw her children reflected in them. UN representatives of the Netherlands and Kuwait said Monday they support the organization's demand for genocide charges against the Myanmar army for their persecution of Rohingya Muslims. "We are very concerned about the atrocities committed there and call for accountability and to refer the situation in Myanmar to the ICC," Netherlands permanent representative to the UN Karel van Oosterom said before a UN Security Council meeting. Kuwait's permanent representative to the UN, Mansour Al-Ataibi, also said his country supports the establishment of an international mechanism to punish those responsible for the crimes committed in the Rakhine state. "Today's report is a very documented report with pictures and videos of these atrocities," Ataibi said. "We support accountability and I will talk about this at the UN Security Council meeting on Myanmar tomorrow. The UN Security Council will meet Tuesday to discuss the situation in Myanmar and the report by the fact-finding mission." The UN Independent International Fact-Finding Mission on Myanmar called on top Myanmar staff military officials, including Commander-in-Chief Staff Min Aung Hlaing, to be tried at the International Criminal Court ICC for genocide committed against Rohingya Muslims. Military necessity would never justify killing discriminately, gang raping women, assaulting children, and burning entire villages. The Tatmadaw's Myanmar's armed forces tactics are consistently and grossly disproportionate to actual security threats, especially in Rakhine State, but also in northern Myanmar, the report said. On August 25, 2017, Myanmar launched a major military crackdown on the Muslim ethnic minority, killing almost 24,000 civilians and forcing 750,000 other, including women and children, to flee to Bangladesh. According to the author, Rio International Development Agency, OIDA. The Rohingya, described by the UN as the world's most persecuted people, have forced heightened fears of attacks since dozens were killed in communal violence in 2012. The UN documented mass gang rapes, killing including of infants and young children, brutal beatings and disappearance committed by Myanmar state forces. In its report, UN investigators say charge violations might have constituted crimes against humanity.